Ready, sir.
Hello everyone. So today's video is related to the defibrillator. So see, this is nothing but basic defibrillator device which is used in ICUs, OTs, right? So what is the use of defibrillator? So those patients are suddenly got a cardiac arrest, right? जिनकी दिल की धड़कनें suddenly रुक जाती है, जिनको stroke होता है heart का, right? जिनका heart pumping suddenly stop कर देता है. तो उसको restart करने के लिए doctor लोग क्या करते हैं? Shock deliver करते हैं हार्ट को, उसके लिए हम लोग डेफिब्रेटर यूज करते हैं. सो बेसिकली डेफिब्रेटर हैव टू कैटेगरीज, मोनोफेजिक एंड बायोफेजिक, आपने सुना रहेगा. सो व्हाट इज माय मोनोफेजिक डेफिब्रेटर, व्हाट इज माय बायोफेजिक डेफिब्रेटर. बेसिकली मोनोफेजिक इज नथिंग बट इन दिस डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज वन वे, दैट मीन्स फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रोड टू पेशेंट, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ मोनोफेजिक. एंड सेकंड वन इज बायोफेजिक्स, एट इट्स नेम सजेस्ट दैट. व्हाट इज माय बायोफेजिक्स, डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इन अ बोथ वे, बट इट फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रोड टू पेशेंट, फ्रॉम पेशेंट टू इलेक्ट्रोड. From certain particular points, current get back towards the defibrillator. That's why it is called a biphasic. See, now this is nothing but Sealer DefiGuard 400 defibrillator is there. So how to operate this defibrillator, how to select energy, right? How to deliver a shock, what is meant by synchronous, what is meant by manual mode, okay? How to install graph paper in a printing, right? All these things we are going to clear today. So first of all, your defibrillator should be on charging. It should be connected to the power supply. That means it will give such type of indicator. How to? Second thing, these are nothing but your control parameters. This is your shock deliver pad. It should be always clean. Okay, nahi? Before application to the patient, you should apply jelly to the patient. How to put it? See, this you can observe. These are the small terminals are there. This is nothing but discharging. So defibrillator is working or not, we are just charge the defibrillator and discharge the defibrillator, right? So from where it get discharged? It get discharged from these terminals. So how to keep it? So you have to just keep it like this properly, smoothly. You have to insert. This is the proper position. How to switch on the defibrillator? See, this is a long press, machine is switching on. See, once machine gets switch on, it is the display, right? You can observe, this is a energy, right? What is the unit of energy? It is in joule. Got it? Monitor, trained and menu. This knob you can observe, it will be working like a mouse of PC, right? With help of this knob, you can select particular parameter, and by clicking it will be goes inside that particular parameter. So first of all, I will tell you how to select energy. See, with help of rotation of this knob, you can go on the defib. Come this, you just see, you can move a cursor, that is a defib. Got it? So I'm just going to wait. So with help of this defibrillator, you can select maximum 200 joule energy, and minimum it will give you 1 joule energy. That means you can use it for the neonatal, pediatric as well as adult. Got it? Now suppose I am going to select a 90 joule. So I have selected 90 joule and long press. That means it is 90 joule has been selected. Next protocol is what? See, this is the what we are saying, shock delivery pad. You can observe these two knobs are there, right? These are the delivery, for the delivery you can observe this is simultaneously you have to press all these two knobs, right? And this is nothing but charging. Got it? So I have to press it like this. So whenever I am press this charge switch, see, charging is in progress. Once you are charged, defib is ready, and simultaneously I am going to press this knob, shock delivered. I have selected 90 joule, it have delivered 89 joule. That means machine is working properly, there is no issue with the machine, right? So this is nothing but how to select energy and how to deliver to the patient, first of all. Second thing, see, come to point, in a defibrillator there are two modes. One is manual, and second one is synchronous. So in manual mode, directly you can select energy and you can deliver to the patient. But second one is a manual mode. Second one is synchronous mode. With help of this, you can select. This is your synchronous. What you have to do? See, this is nothing but your ECG. What? This is nothing but your ECG electrode. You have to connect it like this, right? So in synchronous mode, what happened? It is connected to the patient. Machine will analyze the patient heart data, and according to that machine will decide that shock has to be delivered or not. If there is a problem inside the patient, then only machine will give the shock. See, I will show you demo. Now it is in a synchronous mode, right? I have charged it.
I have to charge it defibrillator and I am going to discharge it, right? Now, if there is a problem related to the patient, see, these are the abnormal waveforms are there. Machine thought that there is a problem inside the patient. That's why machine has give a shock. If patient is stable, no need to deliver shock. That time machine will not deliver shock in a synchronous mode, right? So maximum time, what doctors doing? Doctor are always keep it into manual mode. Okay, keep it into manual mode, right? So one more thing I would like to tell you. See, sometime what happen, you are going to select a particular energy, but that energy has not selected in the machine. What happen? Maximum time, see, come, it have two modes. One is adult, right? How to change this adult to child? You just go in a menu. You have to select defib. See, you can observe here adult. Suppose I am going to set a child. Got it? And exit. And now I have to select a current. I have to select energy, right? So what happened? You are going to select, you want to select a 90 joule, but it will not select more than 50. So that time doctor get panic. There is something problem related to the machine, but that time don't be a panic. You have to just check it out mode. If it is in child mode, it will not more than 50 joule. It is a patient safety. So you have to what to do? Again come to, see, again come to menu, right? Go in defib, go in child, make it adult. It will come to the original form. Clear? So now you understand what is the, how to select adult, child, what is the synchronous, what is the manual. In synchronous mode, machine will deliver shock only when patient has been required. In manual mode, according to your requirement, directly machine will give shock. Machine will don't think anything, right? One more thing. Next one. If you are thinking there is a something problem inside the machine, there is a one self-test protocol inside the machine. How to make the self-test? Come, go in menu, go in a system. At the last, you will get system check. You understood? This is a system check. Make it S. Self-test. Please discharge button. You have to press simultaneously these two discharge button. Now self-test is in progress. If there is anything problem inside the machine will give a fail error. RTC test pass, defibrillator test pass, battery test pass, CPU test pass, right? System check over. There is no problem inside the machine. Everything has been passed. Got it? So this is nothing but system check. That means this is machine is ready to use. One more thing I would like to tell you. See how to come, how to exit from menu. Main menu, you can just go in a main menu and just exit. Okay. Second parameter is when you are going to deliver shock to the patient. See, this is nothing but adult shock delivering pad, but child is there. So company has given one thing. See, you have to just rotate it like this. Inside one more pads are there. Just rotate it like this. If patient is pediatric or child, that time you can use this shock delivery pad. Got it? And if adult is there, how to fix it? You can observe. See, these are the knobs. These are the knobs. You have to just keep it like this and rotate it. It get fixed. Put it like this. How to fix it? Just take it. Put it like this. It get fixed. Clear? Next thing, how to install a printer paper. Maximum time what happened? Maximum doctors, maximum brothers, sisters, they are doing a mistake. They don't know how to put a paper. If paper wrongly put inside the machine, it will not give a print. Got it? So how to remove paper? Just pull it out. Take it out. So this is nothing but your printing paper. Okay. So how to put it? Just you have to put it like this, see, right? Make it small thing at the outside. Insert it properly, right? And just push it. Clear? This is nothing but installation of paper, right? So again, I'm going to tell you in a brief 2-3 sentence. You have to take care. Your shock delivery pad should be always clean. It should be keep it here properly. Before using defibrillator, you can select energy and deliver. If it get delivered properly, that means machine is working okay. Daily basis, you have to check the machine, take one printout and keep
one register for the defibrillator checking protocol in your ICUs or OTs. Got it? And defibrillator should be on continuously charging, so at the time of emergency it will not create a big issue related to the battery problem or a lot of things earlier. Got it? And one more thing, maximum time you are not able to deliver a shock to the patient, that time you have to decide mode, is you have to check the mode, either it is synchronous or manual. If it is in a synchronous mode, machine will decide according to patient. Don't be a panic. And when you are when any doctor is trying to give a shock to the patient, to those people are working surrounding to that patient, sisters and brothers, they have to keep one thing in your mind: this machine gives shock to the patient, that means it delivers the energy, it delivers the current. If you are touching simultaneously to the patient, there is chances of to get the shock to that particular working person also. So whenever you are going to apply defib to the patient, don't touch to the patient. If possible, remove your oxygen mask of that patient at the delivery of shock. Got it? So this is nothing but basic things regarding to the defibrillator. Thank you.